about to remember
this song. Fuck. The swag is on 1,000.
Ex actually just shit on my last chick, and she has what my ex lacks.
What up, what up, what up, Night Nation? It's your boy, Stevie Knight. About to get on one of these things, you feel me? What's good with the watch? Night's watch shit, man. We out here, bro. Yeah, I'm a day late. I'm a day late, bro. I ain't even know NF dropped. I mean, y'all told me the day of, you better get on this shit. Better get on this shit. I mean, it's still technically the day it dropped, it's the 16th, but I'm not gonna post my shit till tomorrow morning. It really ain't no point, bro, because motherfuckers is on this shit, dog. I pulled the video up on YouTube, you know what I'm saying? And then, bro, laid back on it, Knox on it, Crip on it, No Life Shaq on it. I don't know who this girl is, but everybody on this shit, yeah, you know what I mean? So I'm imagining it's only so many damn reactions y'all gonna watch in a day, you know what I'm saying? So, hey, it's my turn now, bro. But look, NF is always gonna hold a special place in hell for me, bro, because one of the main reasons why my channel blew up is when I tapped into NF's catalog on the fucking channel and pow, my shit took off, bro. And he ain't dropped in a minute. Last time we seen anything from him, last time I seen anything from NF is he needed that feature with Hobson a while back. Speaking of Hobson, you know what I'm saying? We got two more because they've been incognito for a minute. NF and Hobson dropped some new content for us. So, you know, hopefully there's some albums about to fucking drop this year. That'd be dope as fuck. But today we tapping in the fucking NF to see what he got cracking for us today, man. So, yeah, the song is called Hope. I was also told to go back and check out NF song Mansion. I did that. You know what I mean? I've done a reaction to that shit too. I've done a reaction to most NF shit on the fucking channel. If you know, you know. I've talked enough, man. Let's peep. And one more thing. Y'all see it. I've been getting a hell of love about this motherfucker, man. I got 99 problems being a man ain't one. If you know, you know. Night talk shit. You know what I'm saying? Stevie Knight shit too, bro. Fuck it. If y'all want to cop, link for all my shit, description box below. Shop, stevieknight.com. All my other shit up there too, man. But yeah, without further ado, let's tap in. NF, let's get it.
Hope. Yeah, I'm on my way, I'm coming. Don't lose faith in me. I know you've been waiting. I know you've been praying for my
That's
soul.
Hard. Hope is talking to him.
Hope.
That's hard. And they're singing ass. Singing ass. Yeah.
30 years you've been dragging your feet, telling me I'm the reason we're stagnant. 30 years you've been claiming your honest and promising progress. Well, where's it at? I don't want you to feel like a failure. I know this hurts.
And the whole get up is different now. He got all white on now as opposed to the black he was wearing. So I know that symbolism is something going on. I'm pretty sure there's a whole symbolism going on right now with him middle of the fucking ocean. You know what I mean? Maybe he feel like it's hopeless. I don't know. But him having all white on makes me think that he's being much more optimistic about things as opposed to like the darker type of content he tends to address in previous albums. You know what I'm saying? So total contrast, man. Especially with a song called Hope. Everything is nothing negative that comes from fucking hope. You know what I mean? Outside of you hoping shit gonna fucking happen as opposed to you going out there making this shit happen. But outside of that, hope should be a good thing, right?
But I gave you your chance to deliver. Mm-hmm. Now it's my turn. Don't get me wrong. Nature had a great ride. But it's time to give the people something different.
Okay.
So without further ado,
he gonna drop the fucking hammer in a minute. All right,
like
Mario,
to
know.
Introduce my album. What's my definition of success? Listening to what your heart says.
Okay.
Standing up for what you know is right while everybody else is tucking their toe between their legs.
Oh.
What's my definition of success? Creating something no one else can. Being brave enough to dream big.
Yeah.
Grinding when you're told to just quit.
Yeah.
Quit giving more when you got nothing left.
Yeah.
Person that'll take a chance on something that we're talking never happened.
Hold on, man. Hold on. Oh, there you go. Got all black right there. Got all black right there. That's the NF that we know right there, man. But this is some motivational speaking for that ass. I mean, I'd imagine it's gonna be a soundtrack to a lot of events, a lot of fucking headphones in the gym, and bruh, he's talking all facts, bro. If that shit don't get you motivated to goddamn get out and get after it, bro, I don't know what the fuck will. What's my definition of success? Doing shit other people can't, you know what I'm saying? Keeping going when you feel like you ain't got nothing left. Right? That's hard, bro. And he's delivering that fucking NF way and shit too, bro. And I know the beat hadn't dropped yet. He's still milking this bitch, right?
What's my definition of success? Creating something no one else can.
Yeah.
Being brave enough to dream big.
Yeah.
Grinding when you're told to just quit. Giving more when you got nothing left. It's a person that'll take a chance on something that we're told can never happen. It's a person that can see the bright side through the dark times when there ain't one. It's from someone who ain't never had nothing and afraid to walk away from more profit because they'd rather do something that they really love and take the pay cut. It's a person that would never waver or change who they are just to try and gain some credibility so they can feel accepted by a stranger. It's a person that can take the...
Hold on, wait. So, I know my struggle with NF in the past has been my inability to relate to a lot of the topics he brings up in these songs when it comes to anxiety, depression, you know what I'm saying, mental illness, things of that nature. It's hard for me to relate to those things. I can always appreciate it, especially when it delivers in the NF form, right? But this shit right here, like, if you can't relate to that, bro, you ain't fucking human, dog. You ain't human unless you just been, you know, gifted with a silver spoon up that ass your whole life, right? He out here talking. He's talking, right? Fire. Run it back.
Being brave enough to dream big. Grinding when you're told to just quit. Giving more when you got nothing left. It's a person that'll take a chance on something that we're told can never happen. It's a person that can see the bright side through the dark times when there ain't one. It's from someone who ain't never had nothing and afraid to walk away from more profit because they'd rather do something that they really love and take the pay cut. It's a person.
Well, hold on, I fucked up. I'm talking too much, my bad. I said that if you can't relate to this, you're not a human being. I misspoke, right? Only a certain type of person is going to be able to relate to the things he's talking about, you know what I'm saying? Because the things he's touching on, only the creme de la creme need apply, right? When you are that strong-willed, motivated, and focused on the goals at hand, where nothing is going to stop you from pursuing whatever it is you've got your eyes set on, right? Most motherfuckers do not live in that space, you know what I'm saying? Doing some shit you loved, taking a pay cut, right? I'd imagine most people can relate to entertaining that dynamic that exists, but those who actually walk that walk and talk the talk, right? Those motherfuckers is different. I can definitely relate to that shit. I could definitely relate to that shit, bro. If you don't believe in yourself, nobody else will, bro.
Walk away from more profit because they'd rather do something that they really love and take the pay cut. It's a person that would never waver or change who they are just to try and gain some credibility so they can feel accepted by a stranger. It's a person that can take the failures in their life and turn them into motivation. It's believing in yourself when no one else does. It's amazing what a little bit of faith can do. If you don't even believe in you, why would you think or expect any...
Okay, yeah, it's like some duality shit. He clowning himself. Right, that's the dark NF probably in the way, telling him he can't do what it is he's trying to do, trying to get in the way. You know what I'm saying? Bad NF against the good NF.
Everybody else that's around you too. I done did things that I regret. I done said things I can't take back. Was a lost soul at a crossroad who had no hope, but I changed that. I spent years of my life holding on to things I never should have kept, full of hatred. Years of my life carrying a lot of baggage that I should have walked away from. Years of my life wishing I was someone different, looking for some validation. Years of my life trying to fill a void, pretending I was in. They get it.
Alright. Okay, he back in that mansion. Appreciate y'all letting me know. This motherfucker ain't playing with this video, boy. They got the balloons.
Growing pains are necessary. very evil, difficult to go through, yes, but beneficial. Some would say having a mental breakdown is a negative thing, which on one hand I agree, but on the other hand, it was the push I needed to get help and start the healing process. See, if I didn't ever hit rock bottom, would I be the person that I am today? I don't believe so. I'm a prime example of what happens when you choose to not accept defeat and face your demons. Took me 30 years to realize that if you want to get the opportunity to be the greatest version of yourself, sometimes you gotta be someone you're not to hear the voice of reason. Having kids will make you really take a step back and look in the mirror. At least for me, that's what it did.
Fighting himself.
Wake up every day and pick my son up, hold him in my arms and let him know he's loved. Love. Standing by the window questioning if that is ever going to show up. Up isn't something he's gonna have to worry about. Don't get it twisted, that wasn't a shot. Mama, I forgive you, I just don't want him to grow up thinking that he'll never be enough. 30 years of running, 30 years of searching, 30 years of hurting, 30 years of pain, 30 years of fearful, 30 years of anger, 30 years of empty, 30 years of shame, 30 years of broken, 30 years of anguish, 30 years of hopeless, 30 years of hey, 30 years of never, 30 years of maybe, 30 years of later, 30 years of fame, 30 years of hollow, 30 years of sorrow, 30 years of darkness, 30 years of hate, 30 years of baggage, 30 years of sadness, 30 years of stagnant, 30 years of change, 30 years of patience, 30 years of suffering, 30 years of torment, 30 years of pain, 30 years of bitter, 30 years of lonely, 30 years of pushing everyone away. You'll never revolve. I know I can change. We are not enough.
Oh shit. Oh shit. This is hard, bruh. See, you motherfucker. You motherfucker. Trying to dangle hope in front of motherfuckers. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, he's about to push through to the sum of this shit and come out on top, right? But no, he can't get rid of that darkness. That darkness is the reason why he's been able to accomplish the goals he's achieved, right? He's been a driving force, been able to put that shit on records and relate to the audience, right? But damn, he got it. I thought he was about to shift the whole shit. You know what I'm saying? Give him something different. You playing, motherfucker. You teasing, dog. Like, the dark in this ain't going nowhere, bro. This is tough as fuck, bro. The visuals is crazy, bro. The visuals is crazy.
You don't have the heart.
Run this shit back.
30 years of anguish, 30 years of hopeless, 30 years of hate, 30 years of never, 30 years of maybe, 30 years of later, 30 years of fate, 30 years of hollow, 30 years of sorrow, 30 years of darkness, 30 years of hate, 30 years of baggage, 30 years of sadness, 30 years of stagnant, 30 years of change, 30 years of patience, 30 years of suffering, 30 years of torment, 30 years of pain, 30 years of bitter, 30 years of lonely, 30 years of pushing everyone away. You'll never revolve. I know I can change. We are not enough. We are not the same. You don't have the heart. You don't have the strength. You don't have the will. You don't have the faith. You'll never be loved. You'll never be saved.
Why is what
you're doing? I'm running away. You don't have the guts. You're the one afraid. I'm the one in charge. I'm taking the hell. I'm taking the reins.
He was fighting it. He's fighting it, bro. He's fighting it, trying to keep that darkness away and have this hope about him. But that shit is with him wherever he goes, bro. Damn. The visuals is crazy. The visuals is crazy. I'm thinking like him in all white, him being optimistic, having this hope about things as opposed to having the darkness push him, motivate him or whatever. You know what I'm saying? I've peaked. I've changed. I've grew. You know what I mean? I've healed. So he's in all, to me, like, he's an all white by himself in this land, lost, still looking for what it is he's looking for, but he still has the hope, even though he can't find it, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, they had scenes of the black and they're laughing at him because he's lost, doesn't know where to go, but he still hope. He's still hopeful about things, right? And on top of that, he's still fighting the dark side, right? There's a lot going on in that fucking video, bro. That was tough. That was tough, especially that last part. This part, I want to see that shit again. My bad. That shit was so vicious. I love shit like this. It reminds me of Venom.
30 years of sorrow, 30 years of darkness, 30 years of hate, 30 years of baggage, 30 years of sadness, 30 years of stagnant, 30 years of change, 30 years of patience, 30 years of suffering, 30 years of torment, 30 years of pain, 30 years of bitter, 30 years of lonely, 30 years of pushing everyone away. You'll never revolve. I know I can change. We are not enough. We are not the same. You don't have the heart. You don't have the strength. You don't have the will. You don't have the faith. You'll never be loved. You'll never be saved. Might as well give up. Not running away. You don't have the guts. You're the one afraid. I'm the one in charge. I'm taking the hell. I'm taking the
reins. I'm taking the reins, motherfucker. Yeah. All right, so you said I'm giving something different. Hope is taking the reins of this shit now. But he suppressed the darkness. He suppressed it, right? Even that's what my interpretation of this shit is. Man, y'all let me know y'all thoughts on it, man. But fire. I've said enough. Welcome back, and goddamn, let's get it.